Today, we are here to discuss one very important topic, preparing 21st century students for global society. The issues on which we will be focusing in this module are, what are the psychosocial characteristics of learners of this 21st century era? Which are the four basic skills students need to master? Relevance of communication, critical thinking, creativity, and collaboration. See, who are the learners of this 21st century? What is the nomenclature for this 21st century learners? These learners are known as Z learners, those who are born after 95. And the members of Z generation learners are born with digital technology. You will find all the learners from this generation on internet and social media. They have the capacity to absorb tons of information, spend several hours a day in social media or searching the internet for information. They are so independent, self-confident, and autonomous in their working styles. They do not want to rely on their parents even. You know, one of these surveys told us that 76% hope of these generation children are derived from their hobbies. They believe that their future tasks are based on the hobbies. And you know, multitasking is a strong trait. That is remarkable. In this digital world, we should have this multitasking trait. And these multitasking traits require 4 C's. Of course, we do need 3 R's. These 4 C's are communication, critical thinking, creativity, collaboration. And the traditional 3 R's are reading, writing, and arithmetic. Let us talk about first the communication skills. Communication skills are extremely important in today's digital world. No work can be achieved without discussion, analysis, communicating, talking, interacting, listening. Now, since there is information explosion all over, you know, the learners need to know how to articulate this information. Articulation, they have to learn the skill. Then articulation requires interaction with people, with their peer group, with the experts, with the academia, interaction with the digital world as well. And effective listening is the pertinent aspect of the communication skill. Till you are an effective listener, you cannot work on the communication with others. To communicate effectively, you have to be an effective listener. Communication is the base of every field. Work cannot be done without giving instruction, discussion, negotiation, advising, building relationships, resolving conflicts, etc. Communication does not mean only verbal communication. It also includes non-verbal communication. And the non-verbal communication is more important than verbal communication. You know, non-verbal means images, sounds, other forms of media, the visuals, they are very effective in communicating. They have got their own impact on the learners. You know, learner can instill the schemas through these images more than the verbal communication. It has been globally understood that an investment in the integration of 21st century skills in the classroom provides advantages on many levels. And effective communication skills is the key to success. According to National Education Association 2015, effective listening and empathy are main skills of communication. We talk of linguistically and culturally for every person in any field. The second skill is critical thinking skill. You know, critical thinking is very, very important nowadays. Why? Because we want to have a good and better life. Why we want to have a good and better life? Why this is a concern? When you look towards the environment, you find that many pollutions are attacking us. Our health is suffering. all the way, our health is being attacked by so many environmental issues. We have to be a critical thinker to find out what are the right ways to help the environment so that the environment in turn helps us. Now, for critical thinking, we should have problem-solving ability developed. We should have our reasoning ability developed. We should know how to evaluate and then to finalize the matter, the materials which are best for our living. The motto of 2030 is the best well-being of the individual. For this critical thinking, you know, our brain undertakes four exercises. One is analyzing the material. Another is reflecting on the material. Third one is relating the material. And the most important and pertinent thing is questioning the material. When you question, then you try to relate. When you try to relate, then you analyze the components. And then you reflect on the components. You find out which is relevant, which is not relevant, which needs to be articulated, which needs to be manipulated. All these aspects, they lead us, they make us to be critical thinkers. Critical thinking is undoubtedly the most essential skill needed by all students, by each one of us. From choosing the right job and better living to solving global problems such as global warming, drug trafficking, brutal crimes, etc. The students have the capacity, they have to build rather the capacity to think critically, as said by Freeman in 2016. Even Conley, David Conley, 2008, finds that habits of mind, see, focus here, habits of mind, such as analysis, interpretation, precision, accuracy, problem solving, and reasoning, are more important in life. Problem solving gives way to critical thinking process, my dear viewers. You need to ask meaningful questions to solve the problems, which may lead you to the correct answer or which may lead to many ways to think over the problem and try to find out the best suited answer for that problem. It is never ever essential that when we have problem solving skills or ability developed, we will lead to correct answer. But definitely we will have the rational ways to lead our problem to the correct answer. The next skill is really very, very important, creativity skill. You know, why I'm saying it is really important? See, you when you see around yourself, you find that it's all information explosion around. You are taken up by so much of information. There you need to have that creativity skill, which will help you to reinvent this information into a creative knowledge. This creativity skill needs to be developed so that you become a diverse thinker. Your diversity can lead to new innovations. So innovation is one prime factor responsible for the creativity. Innovation is the one prime product, I would rather say, for creativity. Then when you are creative, you can work in groups. You can standardize your own role and the role of others. You can correlate with others. The creativity leads you from earth to sky. There's no end to the innovations and the productions, in the new productions, I would rather say. Creativity skill is required in this digital world. You have to create on your own platforms with so many digital tools around you, with so much of information around you, with so much of social groups around you. This creativity skills help you to correlate, to collaborate, to communicate effectively and efficiently. According to the National Education Association 2015, what is now In this present world, considered for personal and professional success is one innovative capacity and a creative spirit. Students will be able to explain their original work by implementing their creative thoughts. Without mistakes, no one becomes refined and creative. Creativity permits students to make mistakes. Educators who help students unleash their creative potential are training them to prepare for what they will encounter as they enter the real world. Collaboration skills. Collaboration skills are important nowadays because the world has become a global village. Anybody can connect to anybody. Anybody can interact from any corner of the world. The Facebook, the social media apps, the Google apps all allow any individual to form a group, to interact, to connect, to communicate. For this, we require collaboration skills. Not only this, the environmentalist wants to work with the genetician. The physicist wants to work with the chemistry person. All of them, they work together to work for a common goal. When all of them have to work for a common goal, what is the most required skill? That is collaboration skill. In collaboration, you need to form groups. You need to form teams. You need to empower team members. You have to build relationship with the teammates. Now, when we talk about countries' interrelations, the interrelations are possible only when we collaborate with other countries. Their environment, their work ethics, their work cultures. Multiculturalism is leading us to collaborate. We cannot lead a multicultural life till we collaborate. So collaborative skills, you know, when the learners have to work across ages, across cultures, across castes, across religions, they have to have collaborative skills. So a teacher must ensure that at the class level, at the school level, the learners are working in groups, in teams, where they have less of the issues. They learn how to agree to this disagreement, their disagreements. You know, every time you cannot have agreements among yourself. There are certain different viewpoints. You must encash those skills in yourself so that you are able to collaborate on disagreement also. This leads to a beautiful world around you. A wealth of knowledge is shared when students work in teams. National Education Association 2015 points out that in today's global and technological society, collaboration is regarded as main factor of student success. The world is full of people from different communities, backgrounds, regions, and students have to work with such people so as to avoid any friction. Educators should teach students how to be flexible, open-minded, accept others' ideas, and most importantly, how to compromise and appreciate others' ideas in order to achieve a shared goal. The actual goal of collaboration is to make sure every team member puts equal effort and input and appreciate each other. This is most important, that every team member appreciate each other's potential and position. The pertinent learning skills for sustainable development goals. Apart from 4 C's, there are other learning skills which help students for productive and sustainable living in this 21st century. Dear viewers, apart from these 4 C's, we have to have some other skills also, which are very essential for productive and sustainable living in this 21st century. And they are interpersonal and self-accountability skills. Interpersonal skills, you have to demonstrate that you can take up team works. You have to demonstrate that you can take up team members along with you. You have to demonstrate that you have got the ability to analyze the team problems. You have the ability to view the team relationships. And self-accountability is very, very important in today's life. We can't have outside discipline bestowed on us. We have to have self-discipline. And for self-discipline, self-accountability, self-presentation, self-control is must. So these are the skills. You know why I'm talking about these skills? Because Howard Gardner has talked that there are multi-intelligences which are working in the society. And the learners are there with multiple intelligences. So we cannot focus on only on the four C's or the three traditional R's. We have to see that we are catering to the needs of multiple intelligent learners sitting or working around us or working in our teams. For this, we have to have the interpersonal skills and self-accountable skills. I hope we are clear about the four issues we started with this module, and hope to see you soon. Good day. Thank you.